It is a law of nature. Every year, IC features get smaller. Chips get cheaper, faster, and more powerful. And this scaling is the engine that drives innovation in the information age. But as the industry approached the 45 nanometer node, a major new roadblock appeared. The problem lay deep in the structure, where a tiny part of the transistor, the gate dielectric, had scaled as far as it could go, just 5 atoms thick. Any thinner, and the quantum leakage would be unacceptable. Was this the end of scaling? Was further performance improvement doomed? The only hope was to switch to an all-new dielectric, one with a higher K value that could be thicker, but that would force a shift to new materials throughout the transistor with all the uncertainties that entailed. It would be the most radical change in semiconductor processing in 40 years. It was a challenge that seemed too big to take on. And even if someone did, it was only half the problem. As 45 nanometers approached, features had gotten so small, the cost and complexity of patterning them was getting prohibitive. Engineers were already pushing the limits of physics just to get this far. Any smaller seemed out of reach, or was it? Behind the scenes, engineers at Applied Materials were working with customers to innovate new processes and equipment, engineer new materials, and test new integration schemes to help solve the transistor bottleneck with the building blocks for a new high-K metal gate ready for volume manufacturing, and help overcome the litho barrier with a new double patterning process and films that enable 32 nanometer features using 65 nanometer litho. Suddenly, the industry could move forward. The dual barriers would be overcome. Moore's Law would continue.